Speakers, Dr. Himanshu Mathalia again needs no introduction, and he has a very interesting talk lined up for us, something new. Thank you very much, Dr. Namrata. Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Actually, the timer should be.
Thank you.
Exactly.
And very good morning to one and all. I'm going to talk to you about something very simple and yet very powerful, which is going to change our practice of especially dry eye, and not just dry eye, many more things in coming years. I do not have any financial disclosure per se from my side, but yes, from the institute side, we do have financial interest in the same thing. When we talk about dry eye, when we classify dry eye, when we treat dry eye, do we actually look at the root cause? Well, we do not look at the root cause. In fact, whatever the dry eye is, we still put everything in the same bracket, dry eyes. Now think about it, can a dry eye with rheumatoid arthritis and melting eye be same as MGD just because their Schirmer's values and their BUT values are equal? Of course not. We know that they are not same disease. They are totally different disease condition, and hence classifying them and treating them under same banner would not be the best thing. Now, same time, we also know the tear film is a biomarker for many conditions, from oncological conditions to many systemic diseases. And in fact, there are different disease taxonomy which are already existing, where you can classify disease based on the cytokine levels which are present. And not only that, there are targeted treatment which are present and which we can use a targeted therapeutics to treat these condition. When we talk about dry per se, we have now knowledge, and in fact there's plenty of literature available which shows us that with the dry eye disease, we find certain cytokine levels which are abnormal and certain levels which actually increases and some of them decreases. And with all these knowledge, we go next step ahead and think about, can we just rely based on either clinical diagnosis, signs, symptoms and imaging modalities to treat dry eye? The idea behind this thing is, if you want to treat dry eye, well, you have to catch them early. What we do here, we treat the sign. I mean, in fact, dry eye treatment is, I call it a signs of damage. You wait for damage to occur and then you say that, okay, now we are going to treat it. So why can't we have something where we can detect the dry eye much earlier, we can treat them much earlier, we can have a targeted treatment, and possibly we can prevent the further progression and prevent the complication of dry eye. So we do require some kind of biomarkers to detect all these kind of things. The biomarker has to be rapid, it has to be quite easy to operate. It should be non-invasive test and hence TFM based. It should have multiple analytes so that it's not based on like one thing which we have like MMP9 kit. It should have a quantification also and not just qualification, positive, negative kind of thing. And with that multi-marker strategy, we come to a stage where we are looking at multifactorial etiology with a great diagnostic power there and more than one factor present. And this is what it brings to what we call lab on chip. Now, with all such kind of thing, what we are trying to do is within a short period of time, almost 90 minutes, we can get a level of multiple cytokines, which we will have as a printout in front of us. And this would not be just limited to, but at least including all these interleukin 1, interleukin 10, TNF-alpha, MMP9, VEGF, many more things to come in. And it's not just limited, it can be expanded in any direction whenever we want. It's very simple. We use Schirmer's strip, and again we have validated and reported all such kind of things, and we are quite sure about how to extract protein out of it and how to do the analysis. And after doing the simple Schirmer's test, we take these strips into sterile vials using a buffer solution, extract the cytokines and proteins out of it. We put it in a shaker, and which sort of enhances this thing. As you can see from here, the shaker would help us to separate out all these chemicals, and which we take and finally put it in the wells. Again, as you can see, there are multiple wells, and the wells are connected to the channels, which are pre-coated with antibodies, and they are triplicated in the test. So test, it's not just one test, it's like three times repeated, and you get an average out of it. And once you get everything, you have the report in front of you. So as you can see from here, these microfluidic cartridges, they are coated with those antibodies, and they are actually having a targeted analytes, which ultimately shows us levels and not just qualitatively that present or absent kind of thing. Few of the cases which we have done, and the interesting part here is the first, all of them, the green one are the normals. The second one are subclinical inflammation, but they were classified as normal. And the third one are dry eye. And you can see, even in those subclinical patients, there was a significant amount of, this is logarithmic scale, so though it looks quite nearby, but there is significant amount of difference there. And we could find that there's huge amount of difference in those patients. How does it matter? Well, clinically, let's take an example. That one such case where we checked the cytokine levels, and we found that MMP9 were pretty high, and the patient had an IPL treatment, and post IPL treatment, the MMP9 levels reduced. Okay, fine. The future direction would be that once you do these analytes, and when you find out that, you know what, there are certain cases where the MMP9 levels were more, then you can do a targeted treatment, maybe like cyclosporine, trelose, and those things. When we have ICAM levels which are high, in future we will have lifitegrast, then we can possibly treat those patients with lifitegrast. When we have multiple of them abnormal, you might have to treat them more with corticosteroids. The idea is, if we are able to detect the root cause, we can treat the root cause. Future would be to have a disease stratification based on these levels, and not just based on gross level of symptoms and signs and those things. We can have pre and post changes, and hence we can follow up these cases much easily, and we can possibly have a change in the molecular pattern, and can have a very specific treatment which is going to be a game changer there. Like to acknowledge these people in our institute, and thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Himanshu. I think that I already know about the work, so if I appeared to be doing something else, that's because I've seen the work, but I hope it was a revelation to at least some of the audience here, and it's something very exciting and different that you've been doing.